business faces many environmental requirements. One requires that they measure all their environmental impact, not just theirs, but upstream and downstream. It's called life cycle analysis. It's a bad idea, and let me explain why. Life cycle analysis suggests that it is not enough to know whether the residuals you're creating are causing harm, but also whether the residuals involved in the various suppliers who make your product possible, and then what happens to your product once you sell it to customers. How is it distributed? How is it used in practice? How is it discarded when it becomes obsolete? The company is supposed to calculate all of those upstream and downstream effects, add it to its own effects, come up with a vector. How much water pollution problems, air pollution problems, water pollution problems, and then try to minimize all of the items in that vector of pollutants. That's the life cycle analysis concept. Lots wrong with it. Let's think of a few. Well, one is, of course, that it's measuring residuals, the things that are left over after you translate energy and materials into a more human useful form of energy and materials. There are always residuals in any product, but the residuals are not pollutants. They only become pollutants when they're transferred to the properties of others without their permission. My neighbor doesn't mind me putting my leaves in his compost heap as long as he's agreed to it. EPA doesn't make that distinction. A residual is a pollutant. It's very much as if, and in fact the case, EPA views the baby crawling across your beautiful new carpet and the baby without its diaper on crawling across your beautiful new carpet. To EPA, both babies have the same emission profile. The fact that one of them creates a real pollution hazard and the other doesn't, EPA seems to be totally unaware of. The silliness of that is compounded when you go to the fact that knowledge about events is localized and dispersed. A residual that enters the water stream of a supplier upstream where there's a rainforest or where the rivers are flowing massively may create de minimis issues. Whereas that same residual in an area where water is scarce, where the river is very vulnerable to even a little bit of pollutant, might actually cause environmental harm. No matter, to EPA, a residual unit is a residual unit, so you're adding apples and oranges. It's silly, and yet it's the way one of the things life cycle analysis does. The other one is it fails to consider the timing when these residuals are generated. Let's suppose, in fact, you're having your air pollutant when the wind is blowing steadily 20, 30 miles an hour. The residuals then can be quite less significant than when you're in a period when the air is constant, when it's a calm day, and the residuals stay in the air shed and can create smog and so forth. Time and place matter dramatically when you're trying to understand what our impact is on the planet. Life cycle analysis doesn't consider that. And yet this concept is now being required, or companies are voluntarily rushing into it, to try to determine whether a plastic cup is better or worse than a ceramic cup or a paper cup, whether an electric car is really better than an internal combustion car, or whether oil shipped by pipeline is better or not than oil shipped by tanker or natural gas or nuclear power and so forth. It's a silly attempt to deal with a problem that is far better addressed by requiring the individual who generates a residual to be responsible to ensure that that does not flow onto the properties of others without their permission, and to let others upstream and downstream from you face that same responsibility. Good environmental policy doesn't disperse responsibility or to pretend to a knowledge level that it does not have. It doesn't try to do everything from the top down. It doesn't require corporations to be godlike figures who can understand everything their activities do to the whole world. It's a sensible proposition that gives you freedom to act and holds you responsible for your activities and others to do the same. Life cycle analysis abandons this concept. It's one of the many silly ideas in the whole concept of corporate social responsibility. It should be rejected.